The purpose of this video is to show you how to apply a background during a live Microsoft Teams meeting with students or other participants. So the first thing you need to do is you need to make sure that you have the Microsoft Teams app on your computer. Because when you click on a meeting link, it prompts you to open the meeting and you have two options. You can continue on the browser or you can open your Teams app. If you continue on the browser, you do not have the option to set a background. So it's very important you use the Teams app. If you don't already have the Teams app, when you open a meeting link, you can click download the app. Yours might not say Mac, yours might say something else because I'm on a Mac, but you might be on something different, and that's totally okay. It'll work on any computer. But you have to have the app. So when it gives you the option to download the Teams app for your computer, make sure you download it. Because again, you will not be able to use backgrounds in the browser. So I'm gonna open my Teams app. It's gonna ask me if I'm sure. So I'm gonna open the Teams app. And I am going to join the meeting. I'm not meeting with anybody. I just want to use the meeting window so I can show you what to do. So I actually left a background on so you can see this bridge behind me. So when you're looking at your Teams window, when you're meeting, you'll know you're in the app because it's a standalone window. On your toolbar, you have different tools. If you click on the three dots where it says more actions and you drop down, there should be a button towards the bottom that says apply background effects. If you don't see this button, you are most likely using the browser and you need to switch over and open the meeting in the Teams app. So again, we're in our meeting. We clicked on the three dots. We scrolled down. Well, we didn't really scroll, but we moved our cursor down until we saw apply background effects. I'm gonna click on that and it's gonna bring up a window on the right side and it's gonna say background settings. So let me take this background off. Okay, so this is the background behind me currently. When you open the background settings, again, just by clicking on the three dots and the background button, Teams actually gives you a couple of different free backgrounds that you can use with students. There might be about 20 of them. So you can use the backgrounds that Teams provides. And you'll do that by clicking on the image so that it has a check mark, and then you'll hit apply. So if I do that, now I have this beach behind me. And it's not gonna be perfect, but considering I don't have a green screen or any green screen equipment with me, I think it's a pretty great background. I can move around a little bit. It doesn't get too messed up. As far as anything you're holding up, so for example, I'm holding up my phone. If you hold items in front of your body, they should be clear on the screen for the participants to see. Whereas if I'm holding the phone on the side, you can't really see it. So keep in mind, if you're using a background with students, holding any props or signs in front of you will give them the best visual. So I can switch out of this by scrolling up where it shows you the no smoking sign. If I click on that and hit apply, it'll take the backgrounds away. So the no smoking sign always takes the backgrounds away. And remember, when you click on something, you have to hit apply or it won't work. So there's another feature where instead of adding a background, you can blur what's behind you. So if I click on blur and it gives it a check mark, if I hit apply, then you can see it kind of just blurred what's behind me. This might be a good idea for privacy reasons when you're meeting with students. And if I want to unblur it, I would just click on the no smoking sign and hit apply. So, like I said, they offer some other backgrounds for free that are already on here for you. So if I want this colorful background, I would click on it, give it a check mark, and hit apply. So now I have this colorful background behind me. I'm gonna click on the no smoking sign and hit apply, and now it's clear. If I was ready to get rid of this window, I would hit the X. So if I hit the X, that goes away. If I need to find it again, I click on the three dots, hit apply background effects, and it comes back up. What's really cool is you can actually switch between two backgrounds. So say I wanted to start on the beach with my students, I would select the beach and hit apply. And now say I wanted to move to a school. So instead of the no smoking sign, I can just click on the school and hit apply. And it moves me from the beach to, actually this might be an office, but it moves me from one to the other. So you can actually switch between backgrounds without having to start over. So as you see, I'm just kind of switching between the backgrounds Teams offers. So this is the background feature on Teams. You don't need a green screen to do it. I'm sure a green screen would help it be a little more clear. But again, you don't have to have one. Standing in front of a solid color wall might help with the clarity a little more too. But again, this is a feature that's included in your Teams app that you have access to. I'm gonna make another video talking about how to add your own background. That's a little bit more of an advanced step, and I wanted this to be a very basic video. So let me know if you had any questions about anything you saw in this video. And in the description box, I will add the tutorial for adding your custom backgrounds. So I hope this video was really helpful. I think this is a great tool for us to use with students to help them be excited and help them stay a little more engaged during our lessons. And we can even use them as teaching tools. So if we're teaching about something specific, we can use a specific background. So I think there's a lot of open-ended ways we will be able to use this. So please let me know if you have any questions.